Please log in into OSM. So when you log in into OSM, you will see a window like this. You will see the name that you had registered with. Okay. So now what I would like you to do is you go to your hometown, search for your hometown in OSM. Okay. So I'll search for Nagpur here. So here is a search window, and I can give search for Nagpur, and some results will come in here. So it says city Nagpur, Maharashtra, and the pin code is given. So I'll click on this and see what happens. So it takes me to the point where Nagpur city is there. So is everybody in their hometown? First thing, is there anything at all? So who doesn't have anything? Which town? Yes. Pilani. It's only national highway, nothing else. So our job is to add the remaining 90%, okay? So can everybody see a edit button here?
Yes.
Just next to the open street map. Just click on that and see what happens, okay? Okay, so it opens a window like this. So it says, welcome to the ID open street map editor. So there are two options, start the walkthrough. It will tell you how to edit with this particular ID. And there is another option called edit now, okay? Right now we'll start directly with the editing. So click on this and see what happens. Something like this should appear if some roads and all that. So is this what you are seeing, or you are seeing something else? Okay, so click on the edit button. There is an edit button. Okay, so one thing is that it will only allow you to edit at a particular zoom level. So as I zoom in, you'll see that even at this level, it's not allowing me to edit it. And at this level, suddenly the features change. I mean, instead of black lines, you see some colored lines. So that is when you can edit it. Are you able to see this kind of map with colored lines? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so in case you are not able to see it properly, you go to the background settings. It's here. You can see this. There is a stack kind of thing here. If you click here, the shortcut is B. Okay, so another thing that we want you to catch up on, perhaps you already have that habit, is to know keyboard shortcuts for a lot of things, okay? So whenever you are trying to edit something or create a document, if you know keyboard shortcuts, it makes it much easier to do it. In this editor, there are three basic tools that we have, okay? So they are point, line, and area, okay? So on a map, these are the three basic features that you can have. So a point can be a place, for example, an auditorium or a cinema hall or a shopping complex. And a line can be a road or a railway track or a river, okay? An area can be an area. I mean, basically it can be a playground or any other part of the city. So these are the three basic areas which you can edit or put on a map. I would like you to identify some major landmark in your town. So for example, it can be a bus stand or a railway station, okay? And try to see if you can locate it within the map. And once you see it, then you need to put a point onto that mark, okay? Okay, so for this, you already need to know the city. You need to know some parts of your city. You need to know where the roads are, where the landmarks are. So this is a hospital that I know from Nagpur. So I'll put a mark here, okay? So I'll use the point tool. The shortcut is 1. If you press 1 on your keyboard, you'll get a point tool. Okay, and so the cursor changes, and I click on it. So you see this, there is a raindrop kind of thing created. So that is your point marker, okay? So now as soon as this is created, you see there is another window which crops up on this side, okay? So now you have marked that point. Now to tell the OpenStreetMap what that point is about, okay? So what is that place that you're marking on the map? So since this is a hospital, I'll say search for this hospital building, okay? I'll click on this. So there is another column here which says name, okay? So is there a common name for this? So I know this is CIMS, okay? And if you know the address also, you can give the address also. If you don't know the address, you can leave it. This is another window that appears over here, which is called save, okay? Now, unless you click on this, anything that you do on OpenStreetMap won't get saved onto your account. So in the commit message, say I'd say added hospital. Okay, you can say whatever you have added, maybe bus stand or a railway station or whatever you know. And then I'll again have to click on save. Okay, now you can see that this point initially did not exist on the map. Now it exists. Okay, it is as simple as that. Okay, so Ravi is asking a question. If somebody adds something, some wrong information to this map, what will happen? Or it might even happen that there will be a road where there is no road. Okay, people might have added it wrongly. So what happens in such cases? So this is very similar to Wikipedia. So even if there is some wrong information about something, so somebody will see it and change it. That's the hope. That even if there is some wrong information put in, even accidentally or purposefully, some other person will come and correct it. Okay. So that's the spirit, that's the community spirit that OSM is propagating. Okay.
So usually if you see the maps that are urban, are always mapped, because that's where consumers for corporates live. So they have a lot of interest. They want to know where are the ATMs, where are the banks, where are the hotels, where do you get coffee. So therefore, they somehow get that area mapped. You possibly know that the people who live in the rural areas is more than the number of people who live in the urban area. But still, the rural areas are not marked. Why? Because they are not the consumers for that market. So what is very important for us is to make sure that the places where most of these youth are coming, because we have selected mostly the youth which are not from cities. And therefore, it is very important that if you could enthuse those youth to fill up that area, it may actually as well happen that OpenStreetMap would be richer about the richer parts of the country. So we don't know what resources the country has, what plants, what crops are there. Like for example, if you go to a rural area, you see a lot of fields. So you can even map at different points of time, saying that, okay, now there is this crop and later on there is another crop. So you'll be able to give that kind of mapping also, because that is the place where the production of the country is happening. Okay, but people are not interested in the place where the production happens. People are interested in the place where the consumers eat. So there is a slight change of interest that we have here, is that we certainly want to cater to all the areas, including urban as well as rural areas, make sure that the whole country is mapped thoroughly. We have made a small movie of a kind of an animation of what was Talasari before we went, and what is Talasari now, and how the map has evolved.
Okay, so next is the line tool. So a line can be a road, highway, power line, railway line, or a metro track, anything that is a linear thing. Okay, so I already know in this place that this road connects to this road, okay? So this has not been added, and this road also connects to this road. This I know because I have been to this area. I know this area very well. So what I'll do is, I'll start editing from here. I'll click here. And immediately you see, there is a line which moves with my cursor. Okay. So I'll put my line here and click again. Okay. So it says that it has drawn a line. Okay. But this line is thinner. Did you notice that? So we need to again, just like we did it with the point, again, for the line, we need to tell what this line is about. Okay, so here, if I press enter, so here it will give me a search. Okay, so I say road. So there are different kinds of roads, right? All roads are not similar. Some are highways, some are like residential roads, some are tertiary roads, secondary roads, some are service roads also. So this is particular, this is a residential area. So I'll say residential road. You can add the name here, just like in case of the point. And this doesn't have any particular name, so I'll just say save. So you see immediately this road, which was not there earlier, now it has appeared here. Okay, it is as simple as that. So now you want to try to add some roads into your town, some major roads that are there, which connect the town, or like there must be some MG road in your town, right?
So we want all of you to add at least two or three lines. So how many of you done three lines already? So we have to wait for some time before we go to areas.
This is part of the Agricultural University of Nagpur. So these are all farmlands, experimental farmlands. So I'll add farms there, which are areas actually. So for this, I choose the area tool. So in area tool, I'll start with one point. Then I'll go here, then here, then here. And I don't want to snap it. Okay, so this has made an area. So it again, same procedure is to be repeated. So I'll have to search for farms. So I say farm here. Okay, and name if any, so I'll say Agricultural University Farms. Then I'll save again and added farm. Okay, so it has been added now. So these are the three basic things. And this is all that is possible with the map right now. In some other versions, you can actually have different layers for different types of objects. So for example, for waterways or like river systems, you can have a different layer which will only show you rivers. Okay, or for railway network, you can have a different layer which will only show you the railway network. So these all things are possible, but this is the basic. I mean, this is all you need to know to contribute to OSN. Okay.
The satellite images that you have here are not coming from OSN. You know, they come from other agencies. If you see the bottom of the satellite image, you will see some company's name. It may come from Bing, it may come from Yahoo, it may come from Google. And we are now trying to convince the Indian government so that we can have Indian satellite image. Now, there are two other ways in which you can do OSN. Suppose if in your area you don't have a good satellite map, all that you do is, you know, take a cycle is the best, or a motorcycle, okay, put on your GPS and then just take a slow ride to all the roads and things like that, come back, you'll get the track file. Upload the track file on OSN. There's something called GPS traces. Okay, these are the track files that people keep contributing. Yeah, if you click on that, you'll actually see how the tracking is actually happening. So somebody went that way, he tracked it and he contributed to GSM.
So this is what we have added for Ambert actually. I mean, this Chavan sir and me went on a motorcycle around town with a GPS unit. And so these roads were added after that. I mean, so this is the satellite map, this is the resolution of satellite map.
If you have an Android phone, look for OSM. There is an OSM app available for Android. There are a couple of OSM tools there. You can use any of them and then start tracking new areas. If the satellites are there, if every citizen or most citizens have, let us say, a GPS unit in their hand, okay, you can actually do a lot of tracking yourself. The maps actually can be made by the citizens and they will be able to map all their resources. Now, what is interesting here is not really just the roads and the buildings. Once you have completed the roads and buildings, something interesting happens. Take for example, after 2 years, the NSS program completes all the roads and buildings. Then what do you do after that? OSM has what are called layers. So you'll be able to create different kinds of details. For example, you can create one layer for just malaria incidents. Like what are the places where the malaria patients are living? Okay, you can create a tuberculosis map of the country. You can create another layer for tuberculosis. So you can create another thing, let us say for a particular kind of pest that is, destroying the crops. And so essentially what happens is almost a lot of data needs location as a parameter. For example, just all the electoral constituencies, you make one more map. So this is an activity-based way of learning geography and also understanding various social aspects and things like that. It doesn't cost much. All that you need, of course, is you have access to a computer and you have access to internet. So it's a very interesting way of converting citizens into producers.